We obviously want to keep things isolated. sorry. I normally finish with the margin. So I start off on the occlusal surface and begin working my way down the axial surfaces of the prep. And the very last thing I try to touch will be the Now we'll get the restoration. We'll apply, in this case, our resin, adhesive resin cement from 3M, which is the Relax Ultimate.
How does it feel right now?
Very good.
Feels very good.
So one of the important steps when it comes to bonding BruxZir is to decontaminate the restoration after you've tried it in. So when you try the crown in on the patient, it becomes contaminated with the patient's saliva. So those salivary phosphates could certainly inhibit bonding. Whether you put the correct zirconia primer, bonding agents, that saliva is blocking those sites. So one of the best ways to decontaminate the internal surface of the restoration is to use a sandblaster, or in this case, we're using a cherecide micro etcher. Within this vial, we have 50 micron aluminum oxide, and this will help not only remove those salivary phosphates so that we have a clean surface to bond to, it will also roughen the internal surface so that we have extra surface area for the zirconia primer and then subsequent resin cement to bond to. So after we've tried it in, we've confirmed the fit. It has become contaminated. Now we're using this Danville cherecide micro etcher, and I'm applying this to the entire internal surface. This is a BruxZir NOW crown, which was milled cherecide. So we have our decontaminated BruxZir crown. Now we're gonna follow it up with a zirconia primer. So in this case, because I'm using a universal bonding agent, the bonding agent also contains some methacrylate and light sensitive monomers within it. So I make sure that I have my orange filter on. And here I apply it to the entire intaglial surface, because we certainly want that MDP primer to come into contact with the entire restoration, including the margins of the restoration. So something that we do is we'll use a suction to remove some of the excess bonding agent on the restoration. And also with oil and water-free air, we're gonna lightly apply some air to this to continue thinning out this bonding agent. And the resulting layer will certainly be the bonding agent, but within this universal bonding agent, Scotch Bond Universal, there is the MDP primer, which is critical for our bonding to zirconia. So anytime we're cementing, particularly if we're bonding following adhesive dentistry, we really want to make sure we isolate the area really well. We do have an ISO dry. It's a suction device. It's a retraction device also to help keep the tongue and cheek out of the way, and it will suction any excess fluids. So a nice way to combat that, and has been proven to reduce the risk of postoperative sensitivity, is to apply a desensitizing agent on the preparation. In this case, I use Gluma. The Gluma is a glutaraldehyde and HEMA solution. The combination of that, again, has been shown to greatly reduce the risk of post-op sensitivity. It also has a nice antimicrobial action as well to help clean the preparation. I lightly scrub that into the preparation. It helps the prep just absorb the solution in. I let it sit for about 1 to 2 minutes, leave it on, and we actually don't want to rinse it off. I just leave it on to the preparation. If after the 1 or 2 minutes have elapsed, if I see a lot of excess of the desensitizing agent, then we'll blot dry it with a cotton pellet or aspirate the excess with a suction. To bond this restoration in, we're going to use 3M's Relax Ultimate, which is their adhesive resin cement. So the adhesive resin cement does require an additional application of a bonding agent onto the preparations. So using Scotch Bond Universal, we're going to apply a thin coat of the bonding agent. I normally finish with the margin. So I start off on the occlusal surface and begin working my way down the axial surfaces of the prep. And the very last thing I try to touch will be the margin, because you may potentially contaminate the microbrush by touching some of the surrounding soft tissue, especially if there's heme or saliva or crevicular fluid in those areas. That just helps, for me, minimize the risk of contamination. So we've now filled the restoration with our adhesive resin cement. Now we make sure we apply that down with good pressure. So we've now seated our restoration in with the Relax Ultimate Adhesive Resin Cement. And then with our resin cement, we will tack cure for a couple of seconds on each side. It's about 2 to 3 seconds. I would err on the side of less time at first, especially if you're maybe new to a resin cement. You don't want to cure for too long. Okay, and we'll do the same thing on the buckle there. We finish off with the removal after we've secured everything in place. We've light cured, and now I can feel more comfortable removing any areas of excess cement. So using a scaler along the buckle and certainly all of the margins, just to make sure that all of the margins and proximal surfaces are free of any excess cement. So now that the restoration is secured into place, but we do want to check all these aspects again. So go ahead and bite down together, tap, tap, and bite hard together. All right, and open. How does it feel right now?
Very good.
Feels very good?